ideals. First, we define what is left ideal. A non-empty subset I of a ring R is said to be a left ideal of R if the first condition is I is a subgroup of R with respect to addition. The second condition is R into S belongs to I for all R belongs to capital R and for all S belong to I. Definition of right ideal. A non-empty subset I of a ring R is said to be a right ideal of R if the first condition is I is a subgroup of R with respect to addition. Second condition is S into R belong to I for all R belong to capital R and for all S belong to I. The only difference between left ideal and right ideal is the position of R and S only. Here it is called left ideal. Here the R is the left of S. So we call it as left ideal. Here the R is right of S. Therefore, it is called right ideal. So for left ideal, R into S belongs to I, where R is left of S. Here, S, R belongs to I, where R is the right of S. What is an ideal? A non-empty subset I of a ring R is said to be an ideal if and only if it is both a left and a right ideal. Thus, a non-empty subset I of ring capital R is said to be an ideal of R if I is a subgroup of R with respect to addition. The second condition is R S belongs to I and S R belongs to I. For all R belong to R and for all S belong to I. Note number 1. If R is a commutative ring, then every left ideal will also be a right ideal. Therefore, in a commutative ring, there is no difference between left ideal and right ideal and ideal. They are all one and the same. Second point is, ideal is also called two-sided ideal. Third point is, the sets 0, the singleton set 0, namely the identity element with respect to addition and capital R itself are ideals of any ring. As we know that the identity element 0 with respect to addition and capital R are sub rings of any ring. Similarly, those two sets, namely the singleton set 0 and R, are ideals of any ring. These two ideals are called improper ideals. The other ideals, if any, are called proper ideals. The fourth point is, a ring having no proper ideals is called a simple ring. Fifth point, the ideal, the singleton set 0 is called a null ideal. The ideal capital R of R is called unit ideal. The two trivial ideals, namely the singleton set 0, that is additive identity 0, is a null ideal and the capital R is unit ideal. Sixth point, if we are to prove that a non-empty subset I of R is an ideal of R, then it is sufficient to prove that A belongs to I, B belongs to I implies A minus B belong to I and R S belongs to I and S R belongs to I for all R belong to I and for all S belong to I. That is, instead of proof that I is a subring of R, it is enough to prove A belongs to I, B belongs to I implies A minus B belong to I. Obviously, one is a sufficient condition for S to be a subgroup group of R under addition. Example, if U is an ideal of R with unity and 1 belongs to U, then U equals to R. Since U is an ideal of a ring R, we have U is subset of R. Call it as 1. We shall now prove that R is a subset of U. Let X be an element of R. So choose one arbitrary element in R. We are going to show that the same arbitrary element also will be in U. Let X be any element of R. Since U is an ideal of R, therefore 1 belongs to U. It is given in the statement X belongs to R. This implies 1 into X belongs to U. This implies X belongs to U by condition of ideal. 1 belongs to U, comma X belongs to R. This implies 1 into X belongs to U. 1 into X is X belongs to U. Thus, X is an arbitrary element of R. That element also is in U. And hence, every element of R is in U. Therefore, we say R is a subset of U. From 1 and 2, 1 says U is a subset of R. 2 says R is a subset of U. So, from 1 and 2, we say that U equals to R. Therefore, if U is an ideal of R with unity and 1 belongs to U, then U must be equals to R. More about ideals. Theorem, a field has no proper ideals. That is, if F is a field, then its only ideals are the singleton set 0, that is the additive identity, and the field F itself. Proof, let I be any non-zero ideal of the field F. It is clear that this non-zero ideal is a subset of the field F. That is, I is a subset of F. Let us call it as 1. We have to show that I is equals to F. To show that I is equal to F, since I is a subset of F, it is enough to show that F is a subset of I. Let A be any non-zero element of I. A is not equal to 0, belongs to I. Since I is a subset of F, every element of I must be in F. Therefore, this A must belong to F. Since F is a field, A inverse exists and belongs to F. A belongs to I, comma A inverse belongs to F, and I is an ideal. Therefore, by definition of an ideal, A into A inverse belongs to I. But what is A into A inverse? That is 1. Therefore, 1 belongs to I. Thus, we have shown that 1 belongs to I. Now, we are going to show that F is a subset of I. To show that F is a subset of I, let us choose one arbitrary element from F and we show that the same element also belongs to I. Therefore, let us choose X belong to F. We know that 1 belongs to I. Just now we have proved. Since I is an ideal, X into 1 belongs to I. By definition of an ideal, X into 1 is nothing but X. So, X belongs to I. Thus, we are shown that X belongs to F implies X belongs to I. That is, the arbitrary element chosen from F belongs to I. Since X is arbitrary, we can say that every element of F is in I. Therefore, F is a subset of I. Let us call it as 2. So, from 1 and 2, we have I is equals to F. That is, the arbitrary non-zero ideal of the field F is nothing but F itself. Thus, the only ideals of F are the identity element 0 and f itself. So it has only two ideals, they are 0 and the field f itself. Thus, a field has no proper ideals. Now we define what is principal ideal. An ideal S of a ring R is said to be a principal ideal if there exists an element A belongs to S, such that an ideal T of R containing A also contains the ideal S. That is, the ideal S is generated by A. Thus, the ideal generated by a single element of itself is called a principal ideal. That is, the ideal S of R is said to be a principal ideal if there exists any more ideal in T having A must also contains S. Then we say that ideal S is principal ideal. Let R be a commutative ring with unity and A belongs to R. The ideal, namely set of elements of the form R into A, where R belongs to capital R, of all multiples of A, that is R into A. R into A is a multiples of A, is called the principal ideal of R generated by A and is denoted by round brackets A, or we can say open bracket A, or the angle brackets A. Note, the ideal generated by 0 is the additive identity, is called null ideal. If a ring R has a unit element 1, then the ideal generated by 1 is the whole ring. That is, the R is equals to the angle brackets 1. That is, R is generated by the unity element. Every ring R has at least one principal ideal, namely the identity element 0, namely the ideal generated by additive identity element 0. Every ring with unity has at least two principal ideals, namely the ideal generated by 0 and the ideal generated by 1, where 0 is the additive identity and 1 is the unity element. What is principal ideal ring? A commutative ring R with unity is called a principal ideal ring if every ideal in R is a principal ideal. That is, every ideal S in R is of the form S is generated by A. For some A belongs to S. Result, every field F is a principal ideal ring. Well ordering principle. Every non-empty set of positive integers contains a least element. We are going to prove a theorem. The ring of integers is a principal ideal ring. Proof, let the ring of integers z comma plus comma dot be the ring of integers. Clearly, z is a commutative ring with unity and without zero divisors. Therefore, the set of integers will be a principal ideal ring if every ideal in z is a principal ideal. Let S be any ideal of the ring of integers. That is, S is an arbitrary ideal of the ring of integers. Now we are going to show that this S is a principal ideal. If the ideal S is generated by 0, The zero is the additive identity. Then in this case, S is a principal ideal generated by zero, that is a null ideal. So let us suppose that S is not a null ideal, that is S is not generated by zero. In this case, S contains at least one non-zero integer, say a. That is, small a is a non-zero element in S. Since S is a subgroup of R under addition, therefore a belongs to S implies minus a belongs to S. That is, additive inverse exists for every element in this S. We know that between a and minus a, one of them is positive, since a is a non-zero integer. This shows that S contains at least one positive integer, that is, either a may be positive or minus a may be positive. Let S superfix plus denote the set of all positive integers in S. Suppose S has 100 positive integers. All the 100 positive integers will be in S. S plus is non-empty set, and by well-ordering principle, S plus must have a least positive integer. Suppose small s is the least positive integer. Now, our aim is to show that S is a principal ideal generated by the small s, namely the least element. That is, we are going to show that this capital S is generated by small s. Now, suppose that n is any integer in S. If we show that the small n is a integral multiple of S, then we say that every element in S is a multiple of S, and hence we can conclude that this capital S is generated by S. Then by division algorithm, there exist two more integers Q and R such that n is equals to qs plus r, where r is greater than or equal to 0, r less than s. That is, r is 0, r is a positive integer less than s. Now, small s belongs to s and q belongs to the integer. Since s is an ideal, Qs belongs to S. Thus, n belongs to S, Qs belongs to S. Since S is an ideal and S is a subgroup, therefore, by the necessary and sufficient condition of a non-empty subset of a group to be a subgroup is that A minus B belong to S for all A comma B belong to S. Using that theorem, n belongs to S, comma Qs belongs to S implies n minus Qs belongs to S. We know that n is equals to Qs plus R. It is here. This implies n minus Qs is equals to R. Therefore, n minus Qs belongs to S, we mean R belongs to S. But R is equal to 0, R a positive integer less than S, and S is the least positive integer such that S belongs to S. So it is true only if R must be equal to 0, because we have taken S is the least. But here it says that R is the least or less than S, which is not possible provided R is equals to 0. Therefore, R must be 0. If R is equal to 0, then what happened to n is equal to Qs plus R? If you keep R equal to 0 here, n becomes Q into S. That is, n is a multiple of S, where Q belongs to integer. Therefore, n is equal to q into s, that is, the arbitrary element n of s is a multiple of the least positive integer small s of s. Since n is arbitrary, we can say that every element of s will be a multiple of the least positive integer small s. Therefore, the ideal capital S in Z is of the form capital S is generated by A, or capital S is generated by A for some A belong to S. Therefore, S is a principal ideal generated by small s. That is, capital S is generated by S. Since S is an arbitrary principal ideal in the ring of integers, every ideal of Z is a principal ideal. Therefore, the ring of integers is a principal ideal ring.